Kunal Madhav, sir, is an accomplished life science professional with 6+ years of successful experience in various research and medical laboratories, proven technical skills in microbiology, developmental genetics, and molecular biological techniques like plating, staining, cell culture, chromatographic techniques, and polymerase chain reaction. Currently, is the senior lecturer in the microbiology department, which is from my college, ITS Dental College, Greater Noida. Although sir hasn't taught me because the year I left, after that, in 1 or 2 years, he joined back. So a very warm welcome, sir. Thank you so much for joining in. Firstly, I would like to know, what is a life science professional?
See, basically, life science professional is an expert who basically commands most of or the majority of the subjects in this particular domain. Although I am a microbiologist, but that doesn't mean that I have a strong command on microbiology itself. Under our domain, there are different type of subjects also. For example, we have molecular biology where we learn about DNA, RNA, and all the genetic related components which occurs at a molecular level. We have a command on biochemistry, clinical biochemistry, medical biochemistry, general biochemistry, biotechnology. So every type of domain is basically covered under the life sciences. So we are basically working in that particular sector, and hence we call ourselves as the life science professional.
Okay, sir. Actually, I would definitely share that microbiology, when in second year, was my favorite subject. I also took biotechnology in my 11th, but somehow I don't know why I shifted to maths. So it was PCMB for me, but I really, really love microbiology and biotechnology. Coming back to the basics, like what is fungi? Because once we understand what is a fungi, then only we can understand what is this mucormycosis.
See, fungi is basically a type of, we can say that fungi is basically a group of microorganisms. Okay. But I am just mentioning it for that we can say, because whenever we talk of microorganisms, they basically belong to two families. That is the prokaryotes, which includes most of the bacteria, and the other one is the eukaryotes. So we can say that fungi is basically a type of eukaryotic microorganism. And ever since this earth has evolved, so from that particular time, bacteria and fungi, along with viruses, they have accompanied the entire living beings. And due to their presence, there have been certain modulations due to which, several changes usually take place. Some of them, they are basically favorable, some of them, they are unfavorable.
Sir, so what is mucormycosis and why it is called black fungi?
See, mucormycosis is basically a type of, a fungal infection which is caused by one particular family of fungi that is basically called as the zygomycetes or mucorales. Now, under this particular domain, there are basically three essential categories of fungi. The very first one is basically the rhizopus, second one is the mucor, and the third one is absidia. Apart from rhizopus, mucor and absidia, they are basically non-pathogenic, and they have, even though if they show some sort of pathological interaction or very minimal amount of infection is commonly seen if they infect also. But when we talk about rhizopus is the most infectious category of the zygomycetes family. So when they are basically infecting, that particular condition is commonly called as the mucormycosis due to that particular domain. Now, why we are calling it as the black fungi is because whenever this group of microorganisms, that is the rhizopus, it starts to infect, the very first feature which it starts to develop is the blackening of the area. Okay, you start to see black lesions over the area, and that black lesions basically depict its name, that is the black fungi.
And so is was it it this used to be called as zygomycosis, and why is it that?
See, it was basically the early nomenclature. It was an early nomenclature that it was called as the zygomycosis or zygomycosis. It was basically the early nomenclature because Like later on, it was revealed in a particular study that not the entire zygomycetes family were responsible, but only one group of microorganisms, that is the rhizopus specifically, is responsible for causing the black fungus-related condition. So that's why they have
right.
now classified under the family of the mucorales. And in that particular section also specifically, like rhizopus species-associated infection is commonly called as the mucormycosis.
Right. And so why is it that we can see different variants of it? Like first we saw black, then we saw white, and then we saw yellow. So why is it that its variants are coming up? And what is white fungi? What is yellow fungi? And why the white one is more dangerous, it is said?
So the very first thing which one must understand is basically the concept of the human body or the defense mechanism.
Right.
So the defense mechanism suffers in an individual in two forms. The very first form is basically the most prevalent one, which is called as the immune system. But the immune system, which are naturally is present in the human body, is also somewhat correlated with the type of microorganism, which is the normal habitat of an individual. And those group of microorganisms
yes.
are commonly called as the commensals. So both of them, they basically, you know, they are basically present in a particular equilibrium. If one side of the equilibrium is disturbed, the other thing is also disturbed. So what happens is, whenever, you know, like this type of microorganism, for example, जैसे हम लोग mucormycosis की अगर बात करते हैं, तो mucormycosis का जो responsible जो आपका pathogen है, वो environment में आपका मौजूद है, ठीक है? लेकिन कभी भी ना आपको कभी हुआ ना मुझे कभी हुआ एंड भगवान ने करे आगे कभी किसी को हो भी, बट वो क्यों नहीं होता है? उसके पीछे का रीजन ये है कि हमारा इम्यून सिस्टम अच्छा, ठीक है? इसी
right.
वजह से अगर हम अपने इम्यून सिस्टम को कॉम्प्राइज कर बैठते हैं, चाहे ज्यादा अमाउंट में एंटीबायोटिक कंज्यूम कर लिया, चाहे ज्यादा अमाउंट में हम लोग ने कोई स्टेरॉयड को कंज्यूम किया, तो इसकी वजह से क्या हो जाता है, हमारी इम्यूनिटी लो होने लगती है. जैसे इम्यूनिटी लो हुई, ठीक है, तो आपने एक टर्म सुना होगा, मौके पे चौका, ठीक है? तो सारे जो जितने भी माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिज्म जो अब तक आपको कोई भी हार्म नहीं पहुंचा रहे थे, नाउ दे बेसिकली गेट एन अपॉर्चुनिटी. अब उनको एक अपॉर्चुनिटी
exactly.
मिल गया है, जिसकी वजह से अब वो आपका इन्फेक्शन कॉज करा सकते. अब आपकी बात
yes.
आते हैं जहाँ पे मैं आपने मेरे से ये पूछा था कि व्हाइट फंगस आपका ज्यादा डेंजरस क्यों है. तो जस्ट मैं यहाँ पे छोटा सा अभी एक आपको पॉइंट बताता हूँ. जैसा अभी आपने व्हाइट फंगस के बारे में पूछा, हाल फिलहाल में रिसेंटली ऑन 24 मई 2021, अगर आपने न्यूज में भी देखा
okay.
होगा या फिर उसके पेपर में भी आपने देखा होगा, तो व्हाइट फंगस के साथ साथ येलो फंगस भी आपका आ गया.
Yes.
ये येलो फंगस है दैट इज फेटल एज कम्पेयर टू द ब्लैक फंगस एंड द व्हाइट फंगस.
एग्जैक्टली राइट.
रीजन इसके पीछे ये है बिकॉज इसके भी इसका जो इन्फेक्शन जो होता है ना, जितने भी जैसे ब्लैक फंगस का हुआ, इनके ऊपर में ब्लैक लेशंस डेवलप अप हो गए. व्हाइट फंगस हुआ, ठीक है, पैलेट वाले रीजन के ऊपर में व्हाइट पैचेस डेवलप अप होने हो गए. लेकिन जब आपका येलो फंगस का इन्वॉल्वमेंट जब हो जाता है, तो उस दौरान में कोई भी टाइप का विजिबल साइन एंड सिम्टम डिस्प्ले ही नहीं होता. अब आप उसको
okay.
कैसे किल करोगे जो कि आपका किसी भी टाइप का साइन एंड सिम्टम डिस्प्ले नहीं करता.
एग्जैक्टली
अब जो चीज सामने में आ रही है, ठीक है, जो सिम्टम्स आ रहे हैं उसके अंदर में पहला चीज आपका क्या हो रहा है, ठीक है, नेजल डिस्चार्ज, ठीक है, नेजल डिस्चार्ज. दूसरा बोन से पस का ड्रेनेज, ठीक है, नेजल डिस्चार्ज कलर इज येलो, पस डिस्चार्ज फ्रॉम द बोन येलो, हेंस येलो,
राइट,
ठीक है. दूसरा इंटरेस्टिंग चीज क्या है कि अब तक ये वाला जो फंजाई जो था, ठीक है, ये आपका सिर्फ और सिर्फ लिजार्ड के अंदर में आपका डिजीज कॉज करा रहा था, किसी और में डिजीज नहीं कॉज करा
okay.
था, ठीक है. उसकी टेंडेंसी
ठीक है,
सिर्फ और सिर्फ लिजार्ड तक ही वो रेस्ट्रिक्टेड. अब वो लिजार्ड इवॉल्व होकर के पहुंच गया है ह्यूमन के कॉन्टेक्ट में. एंड ऐसा ही सेम केस
right.
हम लोग को एक और जगह पे देखने को मिला था, जहां पे बैट्स में पहले कोरोना वायरस का इन्फेक्शन होता था और अब वो आपका ह्यूमन में होता है.
राइट.
सो दैट इज द रीजन व्हाई.
ओके सर, Actually, also, there is sometimes confusion between what is the difference between a sign and a symptom. So I guess sign is something what doctors or what we can diagnose it from, and symptom is what the patient is experiencing.
Right, right, exactly. That
okay,
is the, that
right.
is the main, that is the major. There is not even a single body part which is being a restricted or a confined territory, only designated only for the bacterial infection, or only for the parasitic
right.
infection, or only for the fungal infection. For example, if we can talk about UTI or the urinary tract infection, so that is caused by bacteria also, fungi also,
yes,
virus also, parasites also. Okay,
right.
Same thing is applicable for the respiratory tract. So it is, you know, like a human body is basically a type of, you know, like a full plate platter, in fact, so that the microorganisms can come and then they can basically, you know, utilize each and every segment, and then they, because, you know, like ultimately all the organisms present on this planet is basically, you know, like surviving. And that particular survival is directly related to the Darwin's concept, that is survival of the fittest.
Exactly. Yes.
In human beings, we are, you know, like we are having our defense system. But despite of that particular defense system or the immune system, we are not able to tackle those type of microorganisms. You know, so that is basically the key reason because of which, you know, like multiple infections they are occurring.
Right. Sir, so are these fungi, black, white and yellow, are these contagious? Matlab, these can spread?
You know, like, like it cannot spread from an individual to individual. Okay? It
okay.
can transmit from the source of infection to a healthy individual. For example, if we talk about the black fungi. So, you know, like the very first thing which one must understand is that fungi cannot exist in that particular environment where humidity is absent or the humidity is basically
yes.
regulated. Okay. So,
right.
for the growth and the survival of the fungi, the one thing which one must, you know, like keep in mind is that presence of humidity or the regulated humidity in which the fungi can survive. Okay.
Yeah.
If that environment is basically deprived of the humidity, fungi cannot survive. Okay, so that
right.
is so most of this particular black fungi, white fungi, they are basically this wild saprophytes. They commonly feed on the dead organisms or the dead remains of the body or something like that, like rotten vegetables or the carcass of an animal or something like that. They basically feed on that. That is their natural
yes.
habitat. But due to, you know, like due to the inhalation of that particular soil sample or that particular spores present in the soil, one comes in contact with that particular spores and that spores enters the human body, colonizes itself in the nasal area, starts multiplying, starts growing, and after that they are responsible for causing the infection.
Right, right. Sir, so are there any updates on the fungi? Like, are there more different fungi coming up? Can we see more variants of it? Currently, what is the most update and any myth you would like to break which we might have acquired from the wrong non-verified news?
Exactly. So the very first thing which you must understand is that because, you know, like it is mostly said that those in group of individuals who are on the steroid therapy or they are diabetic, only they are prone for getting this type of infection. The answer,
right.
the main thing is that it is basically like one side of the coin. Okay. The other side of the coin is
right.
like those group of individuals who are basically non-infected also, like they have a very good blood sugar level. They are having a good immune system. Even they are also prone for, you know, like getting this type of infection. Okay, so
right.
that is the very first thing which you must remove from your mind, that I'm a healthy individual. I got vaccinated from against this coronavirus, and then I'm in a very healthy state, and I won't acquire any type of mucormycosis or any sort of disease. Every single disease, even cough, cold. Even that should not be taken lightly. One should take utmost precautions so that they are basically prevented from even the minimal amount of infection which they can acquire from any outer sources, whether from an individual,
exactly.
whether from the environmental factors. So that is the very first thing which one must do.
Right. Sir, what is the prevention now? Like, we have got the fungi. What is the basic, you know, the treatments that goes on?
Yeah, like the very first thing, there is an old saying that prevention is better than cure. Okay. So the very first medicine which one must take is basically prevention. Okay.
Yes.
Apart from that, you know, like there are plenty of antifungal drugs, but currently amphotericin B is the most recommended one. And, you know, like, but one should not directly run for the amphotericin B until and unless it is prescribed by a doctor. Because, you know, like, there was a survey in 2013, India Today conducted a survey, and I think it was the issue of February 2013,
okay.
There was an issue of this thing, India Today, where they published an article that nowadays we are consuming more and more amount of antibiotics. So India
yes.
is perhaps like one of the leading countries in the entire world where most of the antibiotics are being consumed, both in a prescribed
right.
way as well as in the unprescribed way also. So we are basically
right.
making our immune system highly dependable on the drugs or the antibiotics.
Yes.
So we have, you
yes.
know, like we have totally started to, you know, like disbelief that until and unless we take a particular group of antibiotic, we cannot be cured. Okay. If an
exactly.
individual is having a normal immune system or a very functional immune system, in that case, they can be easily cured. Like, there is no requirement.
Right.
There is no requirement for taking any sort of antibiotic or any particular drug, because you know, like
okay.
Most of the infection, they can be, you know, like easily subsidized within the human body within the span of like 3 to 4 days, and in some cases, you know, like it can exceed to like week or so. For example, if you take
right.
the example of the common cold, you are not. Once you have common cold, you are not going to rush to a doctor that I am suffering from a common cold. Now you have to treat me. You have to give me this medicine or that medicine. You are not going to do that if your immune system is working properly. Okay. So first of all, believe
right.
in your immune system. If you are having a healthy lifestyle, if you are having a healthy diet, if your immune system is good, you can be very easily be cured in the home itself. Even, you know, like most
right.
of the doctors, in case of COVID times also, most of the doctors, even the director of AIIMS, Dr. Randeep Guleria, he
yeah.
also said that most of the infection can be controlled if an individual follows the basic measures in its home also. In her,
exactly.
his or her home also. So that is
exactly.
the very first thing.
Right. And sir, I think by taking so much of antibiotics, we are building antibiotic resistance. So the more our body gets resistant to it, then we have to go on to a higher or the more stronger antibiotic, which is again very not suitable for our own bodies.
Exactly. You know, like again from a microbiological prospect, there is another thing. Like, you know, like most of the antibiotics which we consume nowadays is basically a type of broad spectrum antibiotic.
Yes.
For example, if one individual is suffering from diarrhea, which is commonly caused by E. coli. Now, pathogenic group of E. coli is different. It has a different type of structure and different type of antigen presentation. You are going to consume more and more amount of antibiotic. Okay, your pathogenic variant of E. coli is now gone. But there is a healthy variant of E. coli which is present in your intestinal colon. Even that one is also
yes.
disturbed. And if that E. coli is gone, then your body is not able to synthesize vitamin B12 or cyanocobalamin, which is the
exactly.
natural form of vitamin which our body can only synthesize.
Right.
So, you know, like basically you are on the basis of rapid consumption of the antibiotics without like prescribed by a doctor, then you are like committing, forcing your body to go on a deprivation side. Okay, so that
right.
your body is not able to combat the infection naturally. Okay, so that is
yes.
the thing. So you have to believe
right.
in the immune system, or to take the
and we have to build it, sir.
Exactly.
Yes.
Exactly.
Sir, so what is the difference between a microbiologist and a pathologist? Like microbiology, we study about the microorganisms so that medicines or the vaccines can be made. We understand their structure, the working. Now the pathologist is, we differentiate between the normal cell and what is the pathology, how different the disease is from the normal. So we can maybe do lab tests and everything, but what exactly is the main difference in both their workings of a microbiologist and a pathologist?
You know, like pathology is basically a major domain under which there okay. is a tiny scope of microbiology. Because, you know, like pathology okay. is basically the science of the diagnosis. Okay. So right. it is basically that diagnosis if you are having any sort of, you know, like cancerous lesion, right? So that particular yes. cancerous lesion can be basically diagnosed by a pathologist. But if there right. if there is the presence of any sort of microbiological entity which is responsible for causing that particular cancerous lesion, that will be diagnosed only by the microbiologist and then further consulted by the pathologist, and then they will give the final opinion. So that right. is the big difference. Plus there is another right. difference also, because you know, like microbiology also is a total different domain, because you know, like there are, apart from medical microbiology, there is general microbiology, then industrial microbiology. Yes. So there is different type of yes. microbiology also. But only medical microbiology related professional is the one which usually accompanies the pathologist, so that they can have a mutual understanding on the what sort of yes. Conditions present.
Right. Sir, so how, like, I want to know why you choose to be a microbiologist.
Okay, so I chose microbiology because, you know, like I always had the curiosity of, you know, like to find anything, because like right. the very first day when I saw this thing, a bacteria under the microscope, there is a particular technique called as the hanging drop motility technique. So for the very first time I saw that there is a tiny group of organism which basically is moving. And that tiny group of microorganism, because we cannot see that particular thing from the naked eye, but still it right. has a tendency to, you know, to cause an infection or disease and an individual who is like 1,000 to 1,000,000 times greater than his size, greater than right. his immune, like it has a well-built immune system also, still it can basically invade that group of organism and cause infection, cause disease, and even cause his death. So that right. is basically the most interesting thing which I found, which I find related to microbiology, and that basically, you know, made me to enter that particular domain of microbiology and find more and more organisms, what they can do, how can we utilize them, you know, like how can we use them for the benefit of the humanity, how can we identify that what type of factors are basically they are producing for causing the disease or the infection, how can we make treatment related components out of them, because you know, like right. If one microorganism like a Staphylococcus aureus is responsible for causing infection, then there is another group of organism called as the penicillin which is responsible for producing antibiotic penicillin. So you know, like right. even you know, like they are sometimes I feel like they are basically, you know, like those sort of neighbors who are basically very much uncomfortable from each other, and they start to quarrel among themselves, you know, right. something like that. So that is the main reason.
Sir, the best part is the microbes are our friend also and foe also. We need them and we still do not need them. So yeah. it's the both.
Yeah, it is.
Sir, so how to become a microbiologist? For example, after 12th, we have done our 12th PC. Well, I mean, like we have the science and biology wala thing. Now, what is the next step to do?
The very first thing is that most of the colleges nowadays, they are directly offering the course related to BSc Microbiology and MSc Microbiology. And some of the prestigious institutes like Delhi University and other group of universities also, they are also running the courses of microbiology directly. So once if you have achieved a good percentage and if you have made yourself to cross that particular cutoff list, then you can directly enter. Apart from that, there are other group of private colleges and private university also which can provide this particular
course. Okay.
So even right. after, you know, like,
Yeah. Sir, so how long is this course? Like, what is the number of years?
See, for BSc Microbiology, if you say it is basically 3 years long course. And after that, If you go for masters also, then 2 years.
And sir, can we do this after BDS, after being a dentist?
Yeah, you can 100% apply for MSc microbiology in all of the courses, because you know, like most of the colleges, they usually the only eligibility criteria is that you must have a bachelor's degree with 60%
right.
or so, and after that you can basically enter any of the colleges. And if you want to do some of the reputed institutes, then sometimes you have to qualify their exam also, and after that you can pursue your career or pursue your PGs in this field.
Sir, so being a dentist, I will be joining MSc, right? And not the BSc.
Yeah, you will be enrolled for MSc course. Yeah.
Okay, wow. Sir, also, like after being a microbiologist, what can you say? What are the basic career options we can opt for?
See, because you are belonging from the dental side, or the medical and the allied sciences side. So in your case, if I have to suggest, then I would suggest that you can opt for MSc in medical microbiology. Okay.
Okay.
So MSc medical microbiology is basically a 3 years course, and for that you have to get yourself enrolled in any of the medical universities which runs this particular course. So once you are enrolled in that, you can basically start a career in MSc Medical Microbiology. Now, if one goes for just the MSc Microbiology or the MSc General Microbiology, after that, he or she can basically go into either academics or research, and research or research related to the preparation of vaccines, research related to preparation and the diagnosis of various type of infections, preparation of various type of diagnostic kits. Not only that, one can enter the pharmaceutical industry also, where they can basically assist the companies for production of various type of medicines or the antibacterial substances or antimicrobial agents. So that is the basic
thing. Right.
Then there is food microbiology. So those individuals who love food or something like that, they can basically go for that thing. And they can enter the food industries like Amul, Britannia, and everywhere.
Yeah.
Food is basically the major domain. Sometimes, like some prestigious hotel also, they basically require a microbiologist so that they can analyze the food quality over there in order to maintain it, you know, like reputation, so that the customer does
right.
not give a negative feedback.
Yeah. Okay, sir. So, and we can also opt for teaching like you did.
Yeah, that's the first thing I said. One can definitely enter
right,
the academic
right.
and research also. Yeah.
Okay. And so, how can we write or contribute in research paper or articles if being a dentist, I want to do that, but in microbiology? Like, is there any way I can do that?
You know, like there are plenty of journals where, you know, like dentistry and microbiology both are basically amalgamated, and a particular paper is being presented. For example, very recently I have submitted a review article on oral squamous cell carcinoma and its the various factors involved in it, like higher gene expression and the microbiological role. So, you know, like,
right.
belonging from the microbiology domain, I still have opted for the oral squamous cell carcinoma related topic.
Yes.
So for that thing, if you want to write an article, you first of all, you have to, you know, like step out of your domain, and then you have to
right.
perform a particular research. You have to identify that, yes, if I have a particular condition, then what type of microbiological components are basically responsible for it. Then you have to, you know, like opt for some good journal readings also. And once you have plenty of matter, and then you can basically, you know, like perform the research, or you can perform the review article related components, you can basically make and present it in a good journal.
Right. And sir, the exams, if they are conducted, if we want to take admission, for example, in MSc Microbiology, so the exams we have to give to the university or the college. So what, like in general, what is asked basically?
You know, like in some of again, that is basically, you know, like a very ambiguous type of question, but ambiguous because, you know, like again, microbiology is again, as I mentioned it earlier, that it totally depends on the domain. Like in your
right.
case, if I have to mention about the medical microbiology, then I
right.
would just say that there are some universities like All India Institute of Medical Sciences. Even they sometimes run the course of this thing, MSc Medical Microbiology. Then PGI Chandigarh, that institute also
right.
has MSc Medical Microbiology. So the question which is commonly asked is related to this thing, that what are the different type of microorganisms, what are the different type of diseases, what type of genes are basically expressed, and then what type
exactly.
of pathogens are basically involved. And those things are basically asked in it.
Is there any books you would like to refer or any website we can go to for studying those exams, just in general?
Okay, so if you are preparing for, you know, like medical microbiology, then Anant Narayan and Panikkar. So that is
okay.
the best book. That is the one of the best book which you can go for. And apart from that, if you are appearing for MSc Microbiology in general, then there are different books such as Prescott's Microbiology. Then we have
okay.
book related to T.B. Brock, there is Microbiology,
okay.
Microphysiology related book. Then we have Rangaswamy if you want to go for Agriculture Microbiology. So for different type of domain, we have different type of books.
Right. Right. Okay. Sir, I guess most of the questions have been answered. So, sir, for example, we are applying to MSc in a particular college. We will be applying for MSc in a particular microbiology, right? Maybe general, maybe medical, maybe pharmaceutical, industrial,
yeah.
agricultural. So, we will be choosing one domain and according to that, we have to prepare and rest of the things goes.
Yes.
Okay.
Most of the time it is like this,
yeah.
or sometimes, you know, like there is a common entrance test where, you know, like you have to, because as I mentioned it earlier, that life science professional related things, so you have to, you know, like apart from microbiology, you have to learn each and everything. You have to learn biochemistry,
yeah.
you have to learn ecology, you have to learn
yes.
environmental microbiology, genetics, everything.
There may be biotech.
Yeah. So everything you have to learn, and then you have, you know, like present it to... be an individual, or like you have to go for an interview, or you can go for an exam also, and after that, on the basis of qualifying that particular test or your exam, you can appear, you can start to learn that particular course in that university.
Right. All right. Thank you so much, sir. And from being a dentist point of view also, while we study the diseases of the oral cavity, especially in oral pathology, our main focus are in perio. We usually see what microbe cause the root caries, and it was so difficult to remember. So that was the point we understand how important microbiology is.
Yes. In fact, it is one of the, you know, like the core subjects which is basically associated with multiple conditions, you know, like if you are in a medical
right.
field, or if you are in a dental field, if you are in any field related to life sciences, you cannot ignore the presence or absence of the microorganism related to it.
Exactly.
Whether it is dentistry,
right.
whether it is related to even cardiology, like, you know, like there is bacterial
right.
endocarditis, so even microorganisms are involved there also. Like most of the, if it is related to human body, you are not you are allowed
yes.
to, like, you know, look beyond microbiology. You have to focus on microbiology,
exactly.
and then you have to correlate it with the other condition.
Exactly. And so just one last question, I know this will come up, like how to study microbiology when in second year of BDS,
you know, like you have to, you know, like first of all, I know that the subject is quite vast. You have to,
yes.
apart from microbiology, you have to also learn pathology, you have to learn all about the dentistry and everything. So it is, you know, like a very difficult task to, you know, like entirely mug up the entire syllabus and then just go and write or scribble it out on the examination sheet next day. It is like, you know, a very tough task. And even after doing that, you know, like if a student scores more than 80 to 85%, that particular student is like, like a hero in my eyes. I think so that
right.
has worked really, really hard. So the very best thing which one can opt for learning the medical microbiology related thing is that you have to make some tables. Okay, make a table.
Okay.
In first table, write the name of the organism. Second table, write about its gram morphology. Third table, write about its, you know, like various type of culture media or the selective or the differential media on which it, that microorganism usually grows. Then in the next table, you have to just describe in brief about the pathogenesis or the pathology associated with. And in the last table, mention about the lab diagnosis or the media requirement or the specimen requirement for identifying that microbe. In that five right. tables, you can mention entirely about one group of organisms. And yes. it can just be like, not, there is not like, you know, like not a huge load of microorganisms. There are very few group of microorganisms which can be easily memorized.
Yes.
So that is the thing which can, which one can easily, you know, like go through on a day-to-day basis. And even that much is sufficient for, you know, like to remember all the microorganisms. Because, you know, like at the day of the examination, you have to just give it one look that, okay,
Right, and maybe we can draw small diagrams of that particular fungi yeah. or bacteria for in the fact, better like, understanding.
In fact, like most of the time I ask my students to, you know, like not to just not to be descriptive about the pathology or the pathogenesis of the organism. Instead of that, make a flowchart or make a diagrammatical representation. So that is much better because, you know, that basically attracts the examiners, you know, like you, that, okay, it has been presented in a different manner. Plus, you know, like examiners, the examiners, they sometimes have, you know, like around 100 to 200 papers to check. If a student basically makes a diagrammatical representation of the pathogenesis or the pathological condition, so that basically saves the examiner some time. And in that particular right. context, he, it is very easy for him to give the marks. And most of the time, I have personally experienced this, most of the time on the diagrammatic representation of all the pathological condition of the pathogenesis, that particular answer has got more marks as compared to the descriptive answer of that particular symptom.
Exactly. Right.
So I have experienced that. So on my experience, I'm saying this particular thing.
Yes. All right. Thank you so much, Sai. I guess you have answered everything beautifully. Thank you so much for your time, and this was really important.
My pleasure.